Welcome to SAR Learning Center. In this video, we are going to see how to write an assembly language program to sort an array of data in descending order. How we are going to sort the array of data in descending order. Already I explained the ascending order program. This ascending order program video is available in description. Now we are going to arrange the data in descending order. In this example, I am using bubble sorting method to sort the number in descending order. How we are going to sort? Now I am going to explain this program in step by step. How we are going to sort a number in descending order. What is our program? This is our program. What is the first step? The first step, or this is the first line of this program, is move SI. What is the meaning of the SI? This is the source index 1100H. Here this is the immediate addressing modes are used. This immediate addressing data, this is 1100H, that value is moved into the SI register. Now this is the value of 1100. What is necessary? Move CL comma the square bracket of SI. Now what is the SI value is there? SI value is 1100. Here this is square bracket of SI. Here the square bracket is mentioned the particular memory address. This is the particular memory address. In this memory address is containing the value of 07. This containing the value of 07. The 07 value is moved into the CL register. Where is the CL register? This is a count register. This is a special function registers are used in this 8086 microprocessor. Okay, here this is the 07 value. Okay, what is the next step? Decrement of the CL value. Now we are going to decrement. Why we are going to decrement of the CL registers value? Here we are going to compare this operation, and this comparison operation can be repeat the 6 times. That's why we are going to reduce that value becomes 1. Okay, that value become now the 06. Decrement of the CL registers value. Why we are going to use this 7? This 7 is mentioned as the, we are going to take the 7 data is our input. That's why we are going to take, this is the 7. If you are take that value becomes 8, this we are going to take the 8 data. Here that is the 7 data, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's why this value becomes 7. If you are selecting the 7 data, here we are going to repetition operation can be performed the 6 time. That's why we are going to decrement of this CL registers value. What is the next step? Move SI 1100H. Okay, this is the 1100. Okay, now we are move SI value into the CH register. What is the SI value? Okay, in this SI register, that is the SI memory, is containing the value of 07. This 07 value is moved into the CH. Again, we are going to decrement. Okay, to decrement of the CH value, because of the we are going to compare with this 6 times. Okay, we are going to compare with this 6 times. Okay, that's why that value becomes 06. What is the next step? Increment of the SI. If you are increment of the SI, what is the SI register? Okay, this value becomes 1101. Okay, next move AL comma SI. Now this SI value is pointed here. Okay, this point value becomes 1101 memory containing the value of AA. Now this AA value is moved into the AL register. That is a program move AL comma the square bracket of SI. Okay, this is the AA value. Next, increment of the SI. Now the SI registers value become 1102. What is the next step? The 1102 memory contains the value of 77. This 77 value is compared with this AL register. Compare with this AL register. Comparing of the AL comma SI, what is going to happen? This AL registers value becomes the greater. Okay, that's why the JNC, that is the carry flag, is not set. Okay, if AL registers value becomes small, this carry flag value becomes set. Okay, if the carry flag becomes set, what is going to happen? We are going to exchange the AL and SI value. Here that is no need, because of AL registers value become greater. That's why change will not be occur here. That is directly jump into here. Now we are going to decrement of the CH. What is the VCH value? Now that value become 0, 5. Now that value become 0, 5. Next, we are going to check J, N, Z. We are going to check the CH registers value. It is not equal to 0. That's why the recomparison operation we are going to perform. Now, that 1102 value become 77. Okay. Now, the SI registers value become 1102. This value become 05. Okay. Because of, we are going to decrement of the CH register. Okay. What is the system? SI. SI we are going to mention. This is the value 1102. Okay. Okay. Already noted here. That value becomes 77. The 77 value is moved into the AL register. Okay. Next, we are going to increment of the SI. SI registers value become 1103. Okay. 1103 means FF. Okay. This value. Next, we are going to compare these two values. Here, which one is greater? This memory location containing value is greater. Okay. AL registers value becomes smaller. That's why the carry flag value becomes set. Okay. That's why we are going to execute this line. Exchange of AL, SI. How we are going to exchange? Now, this 77 come here. This 77 is come here. And FF is here. What is the next step? Exchange of AL, SI minus 1. What is the AL value is FF. Okay. Clear? Then SI minus 1 value becomes 77. Now the 77 value is moved to here, AL, and FF value is come to here. The FF value is come to here. Okay, now 1102 contain the value of FF. 11 is contain the value of FF, and AL register storing the value of 77, and 1102 is storing the value of 77. Okay, what is the next step? Next, we are going to decrement. Okay, next, we are going to decrement of the CH. Okay, in previous step, that value become pointed out 1103. SI value becomes 1103. 1103 means this is a value. Okay, next, we are going to check the JNZ recomparison. That means JNZ, that is a jump not equal to 0. CH value becomes not equal to 0. Clear? Okay, that's why we are move into here. Move AL, SI. This, now the SI value become 1103. That's why this is a 77 value. The 77 value is moved into the AL register. What is the next step? Increment of the SI. Now increment of the SI means that value becomes 1104. That value become 22. Okay. Now we are going to compare. Okay. This two values. Now which one is greater? AL registers value becomes greater. If AL registers value becomes greater, the carry flag is not set. Okay, carry flag is not set. That's why it's directly jump into here. That is no change occurs. Okay, that's why that value becomes 77 and this value become 22. What is the next step? We are going to decrement of this number. Okay, now that value becomes 1104. That we are going to decrement. That value becomes 03. That value becomes 03. Okay. What is necessary? Now, this SI value become move into the, okay, now the SI value become 1104 is move into the AL registers. This AL registers value becomes 22. What is necessary? Increment of the SI. Now, this is located here, 11. Okay, we are going to compare these two values, 11 and 22. Here, which one is greater? AL is greater. If AL is greater, carry flag is not set. If carry flag is not set, what is going to happen? There is no change. There is no exchange operation can be performed. That directly come to here. If come to here, what is going to happen? Decrement of the CH. If you decrement of the CH, what is going to happen? That value becomes 02. Okay. In previous step, that value becomes, what is the value? 1105. Okay. Now, we are going to check the CH value. That is not equal to 0. What is going to happen? If not equal to 0, how can recomparison operation going to perform? If recomparison operation, SI value is 11. This 11 value is moved into the AL registers. Again, increment of the SI, this SI value becomes 1106. 1106 contains the value of 44. Now we are going to compare 44 and 11. What is going to happen? Now AL registers value become less. That's why the carry flag value become set. The carry flag value become set. If carry flag value becomes set, what is going to happen? SI value is moved into the AL. Okay, now this SI value is 44 is moved to here and 11 is moved to here. Next, AL value, now the AL value becomes 44, SI minus 1 value becomes 11. What is going to happen? This 44 is come to here and 11 is moved to here. Okay, like that we are going to perform. Next, we are going to decrement of the C gauge. Now we are going to decrement of the C gauge. In previous step, that value become 1106. 1106. Okay, next. Again, we are going to check the C gauge register value. The C gauge register value is not equal to 0. This is not equal to 0. That's why we are going to check once again. That's why we are going to check our recomparison operation once again. Now the SI value become 1106. That is a 1106. That value is moved into the AL registers. Then we are going to increment of this value. Then now the increment value becomes 1107. That is a B. Now we are going to check 11 and B. Which one is less? AL registers value becomes less. That's why the J and C, that is a carry flag value, become set. Carry flag value becomes set. If carry flag value becomes set, what is going to happen? The SI value is moved into the AL and AL value is moved into the here. But next, what is going to happen? The AL registers value SI minus 1. SI minus 1 means 1106. Okay, 1106. The memory location contains the value of 11. This 11 value is moved to here and AL value is BB is come to here. That is the value. Okay, now AA, FF, 77, 22, 44, BB, 11. Next, what is the next step? We are going to decrement. Okay, now we are going to decrement of this CH register. Decrement means 0, 0. What is the necessary? We are going to check J and Z. That is jump not equal to 0. That value is equal to 0. That's why we are going to decrement of the CL register. That's why we are going to decrement of the CL register. If you are going to decrement of the CL register, that value become 0, 5. Next, we are going to check J and Z repeat. Now we are going to check the CL registers value. The CL registers value is not equal to 0. That's why the repeat operation. What is the repeat operation? Come to here. What is the register? Move SI comma 110H. That what is the value? That value is contained as 07 value. This 07 value is moved into the CH register. Look at here. Okay. This is now the value become 1100. Okay, this value is moved into the here CH. Okay, next, that is a CH, that step. Next, we are going to decrement of the CH register value. That value become 06. Next, increment of the SI. Increment of the SI means that value become 1101. Again, we are going to comparison operation. How we are going to compare? Now, 1101 value is moved into the AL register. That value become AA. Okay, what is next step? Increment of the SI. Now that value become 1102. It is located here. This containing the value of FF. This containing the value of FF. Okay, the SI register contains the value of FF. This AL register contains the value of AA. Now we are going to check this two data. Which one is greater? This FF is greater. AL register contains the value of AA is the less than the FF. That's why this carry flag value becomes set. Carry flag value becomes set. If the carry flag value becomes set, what is going to happen? Exchange of this operation. Now, FF is here and AA is here. Next, this FF is come to here and AA is here. Like that, we are going to perform. Now, this value becomes 1101 value becomes FF. That value becomes FF. That value becomes AA. That value becomes AA. What is the next step? Okay, what is the next step? Decrement of the CH value. Okay, decrement of the CH value. If the decrement of the CH value, that value becomes 0, 5. And this value becomes 1102. Okay, now the 1102 value. Now we are going to check the CH register. this is not equal to 0. That's why again recomparison operation. How we are going to recompare? This SI value become AA. This value is moved into the AL register and increment of the SI register value, this is 1103. Now 1103 memory location contains the value of 77. This 77 value is compared with this AL register. In this comparison, AL register is greater. Okay, if this value is greater, what is going to happen? This exchange operation is not occurs. Then that is directly jump to here. Okay, directly jump to here. There is no change will be occur. Now we are going to decrement of this number. Decrement of the CEH register, that value becomes 04. Now we are going to check this is not equal to 0. Now that 1103 is the SI register because of already that the register's value becomes 1103. Now the 1103 value, again we are going to recompare. This value become move into here, that is a 77. Okay, next increment of the SI. Increment of the SI means 1104. Okay, 1104 contained a value of 22. Now we are going to check with this number. What is the result? The AL register is greater. That's why this is value is not set. Carry value is not set. If it is not set, there is no change. There is no change. That's why again we are going to decrement of the CEH register. Then we are going to check with this CEH register is not equal to 0. Again recomparison operation. Again, recomparison operation. SI register's value become 1104. This 1104 value is moved into the AL register. Okay, next, increment of the SI. Increment of the SI means 1105. This value is contained the value of 44. 44. This is the value of 44 and this is the value of 22. Now we are going to compare these two values. What is going to happen? Which one is greater? This 44 is greater. AL value becomes less. What is going to happen? This carry flag value becomes set. If the carry flag value becomes set, exchange operation will be awkward. Now the exchange operation, the 44 is moved to AL and 22 is moved into the 1105. Again, this 44 value is come to here. This 44 value is come to here and 22 value is moved to here. Okay, now this value becomes updated. What is in the system? Again, we are going to decrement of the CEH. Again, we are going to decrement of the CEH. Now the decrement operation, that value becomes 0, 2. Okay, previous step, that SI registers value become 1105. The 1105 is contained the value of 22. Now the recomparison operation we are going to perform. That's why this 22 value is moving to the AL. Okay, next increment of the SI. SI value becomes 1106. Now this 1106 contain the value of BB. Now we are going to compare this two values, 22 and BB. Which one is greater? BB is greater, AL is less. That's why this carry flag value, so carry flag value becomes set. If carry flag value becomes set, exchange operation will be acquired. BB and 22 here. Again, BB is moved to here and this 22 is moved to here. This 22 is moved to AL. Okay, next. Now this value becomes 1106, this value becomes CH. Again we are going to decrement of the CH. The decrement operation, this value becomes 01, this value becomes 1106. 1106 located here, this is the 22. Again we are going to check, this is not equal to 0. That's why recomparison operation, 1106 value is moved into the AL register. And next increment of this value, that value becomes 1107. This 1107 value is 11. Now we are going to check which one is greater. The AL register's value becomes greater. If the AL register's value becomes greater, there is no change. There is no change. Again, we are jump into here. If we are jump into here, what is going to happen? That value becomes 00. Now that value is equal to 0. Okay. That value is equal to 0. What is going to happen? Next, we are going to this step. This step we are going to decrement of the CL register. The CL register's value become 04. So CL register's value become 04. Okay. Okay. Next we are going to check the CL register's value. It is not equal to 0. This is not equal to 0. Again, repeat operation can be performed. Okay, now repeat operation, that value become 1100, that 1100 value is moved into the C gauge. Again, we are going to decrement of this value. This value becomes 06. Again, this SA increment of the SA register, this SA register value move into here. Again, we are going to check the comparison operation. Like that, until the CL register value becomes 0, we are going to check the comparison operation. Now, I am moving into the final step. Final comparison. Okay. Okay. Now, look at here. This is the value. Okay. In previous step, okay. This is the value of final step. This the final step, this value becomes 0, 1. This is not equal to 0. Again, repetition operation going to perform. This repetation operation 1100. This 1100 is contain the value of 07. This value is moved to here. Again, we are going to decrement of this operation. Then 06. Okay. Next we increment of the SI. SI value become 1101. Next we are going to move SI values into AL. Then increment of this value, SA register, that value becomes 02. That 02 contains the value of BB. Now we are going to check, okay, which one is greater? AL is greater, that's why there is no change. There is no change. Okay, what is the next step? This step is, that value becomes 05. This value becomes 1102. This 1102 value is recomparison operation. This 1102 value is contain the value of BB. It is moved to AL. Again, we are going to check increment of this value 1103, that value is contained the value of AA. Now we are going to check which one is greater. AL is greater. Okay, there is no change. What is the next step? Necessary, we are going to decrement of the C gauge. Okay, check the C gauge resistance value. It is not equal to 0. That's why we are going to recomparison operation. Recomparison operation 1100. Okay, sorry. In previous step, what is the value? 1103. This contains the value of AA. This AA value is moved to here. Again, we are going to increment of the SA register. SA register value becomes 77. Now we are going to compare this operation. What is the necessary final? What is the result? AL is greater. That's why the carry flag is not set. That's why no change exchange operation will occur. Decrement of the C gauge. Decrement of the C gauge. Like that, we are going to perform. In the final step, we are going to decrement of the this number. Sorry, 01. 01 means we are, then that time that value become 1106. That value is 22 is moved to here. Okay, next increment of this value. Now 11, we are going to compare. This AL register value become greater. There is no change. Okay, carefully noted. There is no change. That's why. Okay, we are going to decrement of the CH. Now the CH register value becomes 0. Okay, now we are going to check that value is equal to 0. What is this? Come to CL. CL is also we are going to decrement it by 1. That's now that value becomes 0. Again, we are going to check JNZ. That is the CL register value is also 0. That's why the program is ended. End of this program, this is the final result. The 1101 memory location contains the value of FF. 1102 memory location contains the value of BB. 1103 value contains the value of AA. And 1104 contains the value of 77, 44, 22, and 11. This is the output. Now the number is arranging from largest to smallest. Okay. Now we are going to execute this program by using this 8086 emulator. Okay, this is the 8086 emulator. In this emulator, this is the program already I explained in by using this PowerPoint presentation. Now we are going to emulate this program. There is no error. Okay, now view memory location. Our memory location, that is a 1100. Okay. In this 1100 location contain the value of 07 initially. Next, what is the necessary data? The necessary data is AA 77. Next, FF 22 11 44 and BB. Okay, this is our input data. Now we are going to execute our program. If you want check by using the simulator, we are use single step execution. Each and every step the data will be updated here. This is the special function register. This is the SI register. Okay. Now the single step execution, like that we are going to execute step by step. If you want run in a single stroke, if you are click the run operation. If you are finishing this operation, now we look at here CX value, that is CH value is updated and CL registers value is also updated. If you reach the both value become zero, the program is halted. Okay, now we are going to check the result. The output registers value become 1101 memory location under the value of FF, 1102 memory location under the value of BB, AA, 77, 44, 22, 11. Okay, the number is arranging from largest to smallest. This is the program of the descending order. This is the program of the descending order. Okay, thank you.